Today's the 22nd of September and we're off on our travels again. So we decided to go by bus to the airport and we just managed to hopefully get a little bit of a lull between the rain. It's been raining this morning, tiny bits of blue sky up there, but not very much. But the bus is due in the next, the next minute or so. That's about the extent of the blue sky.
Stop where you said, aren't you?
Here's the bus. So to get to the airport we have to get two buses. So we've just done the first bus, which was on time, no problem at all, and we've got a 5 minute wait for the next one to take us to the airport. You may ask, why on earth are we doing that? Why don't we just drive there? Well, driving means it's about a 45 euros, 50 euros for parking. And if we get a taxi, it's 25 euros each way, that's 50 euros again. And well, we get free buses and we're traveling very light, so it's not really any difficulty. I'll be coming back on my own, and so for me it'll be just as easy to get on the bus, so that's why we're doing it. So here we are, we got to the airport, no problems at all very efficient, and the first place we come to is the board, locate the flight and find out where the counters are so we can take our bags and drop them off. We have bags to drop off this time. It's not usual for us, usually we travel with our bags, but today we're not. Well, that's it, the bags are all checked in and we're just waiting for our son before we go through security. And well, we've only got our little rucksacks to go with us, so it should be quite straightforward this time.
Let's hope.
Well, we're through security now and we've just got that long walk to Terminal A because we're going to England. Well, the boarding gate has come up, but on the notice board it actually says that our flight's going to be a little bit delayed. Only about half an hour, so I hope that's all it is, otherwise it's going to cause problems at the other end. Well, we're gradually getting them. Still got to wait on the aeroplane though. All boarded now and ready for takeoff.
Before takeoff, please study the safety card located within the area you are seated, as it includes important safety information specific to this aircraft type.
still find a winning line. The pressure meant that the cold all in the final just of a good up. Three doublets, two in the front and only one in the rear. Only in the rear you'll find maybe changing facilities. We would like to remind you this is a strictly non-smoking flight and the consumption of your own alcohol is not permitted. Shortly the cabin crew will be passing through the cabin with our in-flight service. For now we invite you to sit back, relax and enjoy the flight with us. Thank you.
Well, we're off the plane now. We've just got to head to immigration. Looks like it's another long and winding road. Unfortunately, a TUI flight's just come in at the same time, so there'll be a lot of people going through here. It doesn't feel like 2 minutes since I was last at Bournemouth Airport, but here I am, but this time I'm all on my own, and it's just going to stay in England for a few days more, but I'm off to Majorca, and so we've just come through, and I'm with the rest of the family who are also going back to Majorca, and well, everything's pretty smooth, so let's see how the rest of the flight goes. Everything's looking pretty good so far. Looks as though we might get away on time. We were delayed coming, but looks as though the return flight's going to be okay. There's a plane there, and we're all ready to get on, and we've still got 25 minutes, so as long as they can do a quick turnaround. We're moving in the right direction now. Back where we started, there's A16, that's where we started this journey, and now we're at least I am back in Majorca. Quite uneventful flight, everything bang on time. In fact, we landed about 10-15 minutes earlier, so all good for me. Just got to get out of the airport now. It's 10 to 10 in the evening. It's Sunday evening, it's still quite busy here. Just going to go through passport control now. I think that's the quickest I've ever been through security. The electronic machine worked perfectly first time, and the stamping man was very efficient and didn't stamp my passport. So, very good. Just got the walk to do now. It is quite a walk at Palmer Airport. On and on and on, corridor after corridor. Just approaching the point of no return. It's a double door, and you just have to keep walking, otherwise sirens start going off. Certainly don't try and turn around and walk backwards. They don't like that. Walk straight at the door, a bit like Get Smart, if you ever remember that one. And more corridors to walk through. But we're not going up there. We're going down to the right now. Nearly out. And at the bottom here we have the baggage. The baggage collection point. And this is actually working, so I get speeded on my way. How good is that? Pretty pictures to look at. If you do have bags that are checked in, and the notice board at the end here tells you which carousel you've got to go to in order to collect your baggage. I don't have any baggage coming back. Left my suitcase in England. So there we go. You just find your flight on the notice board there, and that'll tell you which belt. And this is a long, long way of lots and lots of belts. I'm on my way out though now. If you're connecting, or if you've got some other things, questions with Ryanair, who I've just come with, and there's the office. Just come down here. There's currently no customs as such, but that's what these lines are for, if you've got something to declare. They've not really got round to doing that yet though, so we just go through the nothing to declare, and hopefully there are no issues. So if you have got something to declare, that's where you'd go. Not even anybody manning that. But most people just go through the exit. Which is what I will do. If you're on a holiday with a tour company, there should be someone there to meet you. And they will tell you where to go and to get onto your coach. If you're flying like me, nobody come to meet me today, so I just go down here. You either get a taxi or I'm going to try and get a bus. It's a bit late on a Sunday evening, so it either will or won't work. If not, I'll end up in a taxi. We'll see. It's 10 o'clock Sunday night. Plenty of taxis down there, look. All those green lights. I'm going to see if I can find an A1 bus that will take me into Palma. I think there's one there. Am I going to make it? We'll soon find out. There's my bus. Started off straight away. Very warm in the bus. Hope the air conditioner comes on. Somebody's just given me a seat, so let's ride on into Palma now. I don't think that could have worked out better. I got the bus into Palma, walked around to Sindicato, where I catch normally the 47, and the 46 was there, but it also goes to Geneva, so I'm on a bus. At the moment it's empty, but I think it's going to fill up.